Okay, hi Matthias and Barun. Thank you for being able to do this interview with me. First of all, can you tell me something about your business from XT AI?
Sure. Thank you, Art, for having us. It's really nice to have the opportunity to tell a little bit about us and our project. About us, our company is called Exponential Technologies. We are developing artificial intelligence software platform for industrial applications. Main focus of this is the development of materials and chemical compositions and the development of process parameters and production parameters. One of our main focuses is additive manufacturing, and there we work with different kind of additive manufacturing technologies like SLM, SLS, FFF, SLA, and others, and basically optimize printing parameters for good printing outcomes.
Okay. Yes, and you had a special ID, product ID for this experiment. Can you tell me about that?
Sure. What we found is that there is basically like two tiers of drones or of drone bodies when it comes to fixed wing, especially drones. These are like a very, very expensive composite material drones where only the drone body can cost already 20,000 euros and up. So this is like the premium class, let's say. And then at the bottom end, there comes like drone bodies which are made from foam, PU foam and similar materials, which you can have for a couple of hundred euros and which are not very like stable and have a lot of problems. So this is like the, let's say, the hobby class. And the problem is in between, there is not much. But in between, there is a market. If you see, there is a lot of applications for this, like, for example, in firefighting. We live in Latvia. Here's a lot of forest. We have a lot of problem with forest fires. So there is a lot of room in between where you actually could use fixed-wing drones for looking at the forest and basically finding these forest fires. The problem is that for firefighting departments, often investment of 20,000-30,000 euros is way too big. So there is a room in between where they would be happy to have like a professional drone, but for a price that is more affordable to them. And there are many other applications where this is applicable.
And where does the additive manufacturing help in the production of that fixed wing drone?
The thing is, when you build a drone, you have to look at two things. First of all, it's you have to build something that is stable enough to fly. That's clear. Yeah. And second of all, you have to also print something that is lightweight, because the lighter it is, the more payload you can put. So it's clear this can be solved by additive manufacturing, because you can print very lightweight by changing your infill, for example, changing printer parameters, but you can make it also in a way that it's still stable. And additionally, it has a benefit that you can change the size and form of the payload compartment, which is also important.
Yeah. At the beginning of the project, you maybe expected some challenges, but did that came out, or did you address other challenges?
One definitely was to reduce the weight of a printed fixed-wing drone body by at least by 30% compared to the commercially available products, and to reduce the 3D printed body production cost at least by 50 euros. Well, initially, so selecting the right material was also quite tough for us initially.
Okay. And how did you relate with AMable and with help by services of AMable? Did you have some use of that?
Absolutely. So the service what we used was AMable materials. They were able to understand what we're expecting from them. So the objectives were more clearer and more comprehensible. And they also had to give us certain inputs in terms of deciding the materials as well. And they were also helpful in having a constant call with us. Every alternative weeks, we happened to talk to, especially with Margot and Art Williams, who are very helpful in this process, in this journey of 3D printing this fixed wing drone body prototype.
Okay, thank you. And how far did you progress with your product? Do you have an idea when you really will be able to produce it?
So we're currently proceeding, at least with a couple of tests. We'll proceed further. It's of course a question. I mean, we're at the beginning. As I said before, we are more focusing on the software side of that. So the question is, do we want to sell this drone as exponential technology? Do we want to license it out? Do we want to find other partners? So this we're currently checking a little bit the situation.
Of course, your software is especially useful for additive manufacturing. Do you already have more business on additive manufacturing together with your own software product?
We have other projects with FFF printing. However, I would say currently our biggest focus is SLM printing because they're the widest industrial applications, what we see. And it is the most complicated of the printing types, what we see. So we see that a lot of all our projects is basically in finding the right parameters for SLM printing.
Okay, thank you. So if you resume for now, how was your experience with the AMable project?
Really good. Was really interesting project. We learned a lot. It's not just about. It's of course we learned a lot about 3D printing and about engineering, but also about project management. Also from material perspective, we had a good overview. Also through the combination or the talks with you from TNO and from Brightlands about the materials. It was very interesting. Also comparing different kind of material types, different kind of printing methods for what we were doing. It was in general very, very interesting for us as a team to participate and to learn more about additive manufacturing, about materials, but also about running a project and having a good time doing it, right? That's most important.
Varun, also thank you very much for this interview, and Matthias.